item 10 on page 69, that's the budget for 2016-17. Peter, if you want to take us through that report, please.
Yes, thanks, Chair. There are one or two minor amendments due to typos, which Maddy's got a sheet she can pass around to the room. Basically, in each case, this proposal on the levy, our student digital was read 14 because of the surrounding errors. Elsewhere on page 89, paragraph 10.1, fix should read 75,492,312, and the number at 11.2 should be 9.245 million rather than 9.215 million, reflecting some additional support for the general fund. Authority members are asked to consider the budget proposals, taking the authority to the end of 2015-16, added to 2016-17, together with a forward look into the medium term financial prospects, and including the proposed capital programme. Members' attention is also drawn to the appendices which outline as Appendix 1, the detailed revenue budgets and reserves available over the medium term. Appendix 2, which shows levy options that have been considered. Appendix 3, which outlines the proposed capital programme. And Appendix 4, which shows how the proposed levy is to be apportioned under the existing mechanism. Starting with the revised estimates, I'll take very briefly through some comments on that. Pages 92 to 94 of the report shows where the changes are on the revised estimates and shows that we've come in slightly under what we, quite well under what we anticipated, because at the time we set the budget last year, we were unable to take account of the interim contracts, which have continued to be successful. And there was a slight delay in opening the alternation PRC. So rather than taking money out of balances at the end of this year, we should be able to contribute two balances, which helps to carry forward 16 million into next year. This is, for those members who are on the Merseyside Holdings group, only going to be possible if we manage to have that meeting with Merseyside Holdings and get money from the company that is due to be given back to the authority. Proposed budget for 16-17, it's been a process that's taken account of concerns from colleagues in districts about their overall funding levels, which are being restricted quite heavily. Our members' views have been sought through four planning panels, and Carl, the chair, has been known to lead the chief executive to seek views on where the budget should go to. We've also included within the budget papers a proposal for a number of savings, totalling £500,000, including HWRC service reductions, closure of a visitor centre, and the removal of much of the support for apprentice schemes in districts. There are also a number of smaller service reductions in there. In overall terms, the net cost of our services, despite these savings initiatives, will be likely to increase by £3.8 million next year, which means that the cost of the authority services is almost £10 million more than the current levy level. The main reason for this is that we've been protecting the levy from our costs by buffering from reserves over the last 2 years, and now we're moving into a different contracting period. We've got a new HWRC opening in Liverpool, which will add £1 million to our costs as an authority. We're moving from the interim contracts, which saved us money, and landfilling into the RRC in its first year of operation, which is a very good contract. And over time gives us lots of opportunities as recycling rates increase to start developing income streams as spare capacity within the contract is sold. However, in the early years of the contract, that spare capacity doesn't exist, and so we're not able to develop those income streams. So it becomes an expensive contract in the transitional period. Thereafter, it should balance out. Elsewhere, we've got some savings from continued employee reductions, which is unfortunately offset by increases in national insurance payments and employee pension costs. And there's also a reduction in the amount of recycling credits claimed by some councils, which is offset some of our logistic costs. We have had a number of pressures financially over the year, and what we've been doing, as I said, alluded to before, is we've been supporting the levy through use of our balances. That can only carry on for a limited time. We have some facility to support the levy from our balances once again. And we had a proposal that we needed to start closing the gap between the levy £2 million contribution from the authority's general fund. The year after, we would need a higher increase in the level of the levy, and the year after that, quite a substantial increase in the levy. The chief executive and the chairperson have been meeting with the police chief executive and district councils, as I've said, to work out how to ensure that the gap between our spending and our levy is closed, both by service review and also by looking at ways to increase the levy in a fair way. That's probably as much as I need to say on that part of the budget. I'll just reflect slightly the capital programme, which is in Appendix 3 on page 119. The capital programme shows what the odd swan HWRC is costing in capital terms, which reflects some slight delays. There may be a little bit more spending on that. We're in dispute over an amount of money on that. Elsewhere, the capital programme is being pared back significantly. We don't have any significant developments over the next 2 to 3 years that we're planning within the capital programme. And I think that's probably as much as you need for me at the moment, Chair.
Questions or comments?
Thank you, Chair. The proposed amendment is to recommendation 3 on page 69 of the agenda, and it reads that the authority sets the levy at the same cash level for each constituent council as they were levied in 2015-16, subject to the authority receiving in writing from every constituent council confirmation that they agree this change to the levy mechanism for 2016-17 only. If unanimous agreement is not received by the 12th of February 2016, the overall levy for 2016-17 will remain at the same level as 15-16, but will be apportioned on the existing levy mechanism basis. Each of the options will require an additional £655,910 contribution from balances. Further, that a strategic review is undertaken of the whole system of collection, treatment and disposal, the levy mechanism and the arrangements. That the review is undertaken by using independent expertise with the terms of reference agreed by the lead local authority's chief executives and the chief executive of this authority in consultation with the chair of the combined authority, and to be concluded by June 2016.
Do we have a second for that? So we've heard the amendment. So if we don't have any further questions on Peter's report, can I go to page 69 and I'll go through the recommendations one by one. That is agreed. Okay. So item 1, do we agree? Agreed. Item 2. Recommendation 3, do we agree the amendment? Colleagues, staff, council clerk office tabled. Can that be agreed? Is that agreed? Thank you. Recommendation 4, can we agree? Agreed. Item 5, can that be agreed? And recommendation 6, can that be agreed? Agreed. Thank you. Thanks very much, Colin. So we've accepted the amendments on recommendation 3. Okay. Thank you. So we go on to item 11, which is the community fund for 2016-17. And Carl, you're going to take us through that report.
Thank you, Chair. Members are asked to consider the community fund for 2016-17. A number of options in front of you. The recommendation is to remain with the status quo, option 1. There are a couple of typos I would just point to before you agree the report, hopefully. On the recommendation, it should read, detailed at paragraph 3.1, not 3.2, on page 1, 2, 3. Thank you. £7,000. And again, the final paragraph, 9.3 on page 13. Again, it should read option one, status quo, paragraph 3.1. That was a typo. Apologies for that. So you've been asked to approve the community fund on the same basis as last year, the same amount as last year. I'm very pleased with this report. If you look at the outputs and outcomes from what is a relatively modest community fund given to organisations, paragraphs 2.6 and 2.7, I think you get an idea of the kind of gearing and leverage, the value we get from what is a relatively modest fund. I'm very pleased as well that there is an attached report and an infographic which helps explain what the outcomes and outputs of this activity is. These are very well received, small amounts of funding for community groups and charities. Fantastic results by these people, and I cannot praise them highly enough. They do an extremely important part of our waste prevention and reuse work. I recommend the report to you, Chair. Thank you.
See that, but we're just going to get some more information on those facts and figures.